So we moved here, I guess, beginning of March, and I love the location. It's really handy for us too, because we are in the process of putting the conservation easement on the newly acquired. It's now about 409 acres of the Kester Mountain Reserve that will be placing a permanently protected conservation easement on it for the city of Fayetteville. So it's nice to be close by to that. But I'm only going to speak for like 10 minutes, and I'll answer your questions and let y'all have your meeting. But just kind of who we are, what we do, and any questions you have. But is anybody familiar with land trust? I know some of you probably are. Yeah, okay. Our land trust was formed in 2003 by a group of business and community leaders in Northwest Arkansas who, you know, we were really growing during that time too as a region. Northwest Arkansas changing like crazy. And they kind of said, you know, there needs to be some thought put into what we're not going to develop at the same time that we're looking at what we are going to develop. And there needs to be some mechanism for voluntary people, landowners, municipalities, developers who are interested in permanent land protection to have a way to do that that's local. And so that's kind of how we were formed. As kind of the life cycle of nonprofits goes, it was the board of directors that sort of did everything and just bit off a little bit here and there, not too much over the years, and then decided, you know, we need staff, it's time to kind of grow up as a land trust. So about 3.5 years ago, I got a little funding to hire a part-time executive director, and that wasn't me, but was almost, what, there was a gal who did the job first, and then she needed to take another job, so I filled her spot, and I've been here about 3.5 years. Since that time, we have become accredited, so we're the first accredited land trust in the state. We're the first actually in Oklahoma, Missouri, or Arkansas, and that's through the Land Trust Alliance Accreditation Commission. And that was a really long process. It's not an easy thing to achieve, so we're real proud of it. And, you know, as with any accreditation certification, they go through everything from your board development stuff to your financial processes and accounting. And certainly for a land trust, because we're doing permanent land protection deals, they look a lot at your easements, that's your baseline report, that your monitoring history for your properties, have you had any violations, how have you dealt with them, a whole lot of policies and procedures to put in place. So that's really a lot of what I try to focus on. And now we have 3 full-time staff, so we've really taken off in the last 3 years, and more than doubled the amount of acreage that we confer each year. Let's see, we're homegrown. That was one thing that was important about our land trust. There are some other land trusts around that aren't dedicated just to Northwest Arkansas. And we really felt like there's so much going on in these 4 counties, particularly 2 of those counties, but Benton, Carroll, Madison, and Washington counties are, that's our core focus area. We go outside of that, trying on a case-by-case basis, but I'd say our core is those 4 counties. But particularly in Benton and Washington County, a lot of change is happening. So we're here, we live here, we work here, we're focused here. And some things that have kind of come along in good timing with us to kind of where we're at as a fully staffed accredited land trust now is an open space plan for where Benton and Washington counties is underway. The Northwest Regional Planning Commission is kind of overseeing that. They're going to be also planning as a consultant. We're on the steering committee and the implementation team. There are natural resource teams that, you know, basically what will come of that is the map. Probably a lot of you are familiar with green space, open space plans. Maybe you've come to the public to put sessions that have been here so far. But, you know, there will be a map that kind of says, here are the places that will be important to protect. Everything from local farms that provide our local foods to, you know, very rapidly disappearing wetlands and prairies that might be left, forested areas, a big focus on water quality, and that's something that we're already doing in partnering with the watershed groups here, particularly Beaver Watershed Alliance and Beaver Water District, who sells the water, you know, to everyone, working with them to reach out to landowners along particularly the West Fork and Warrigal and try to get land protected in those riparian areas and around the lake. So that's something that's ongoing and it's kind of folded into this now broader open space plan that's happening. Real focused on wildlife habitats. In fact, John Rule is one of the landowners we've worked with to permanently protect his 151 acres there on Frog Bayou and to make sure that's protected for wildlife, biodiversity, and perpetuity. So kind of the two ways that we protect land, one are accepting donations of conservation easements. So the landowner continues to own the land, they can sell it, they can pass it on to their heirs, but the easement stays with the property, and it's our job to write the easement and to monitor that easement and cross all the T's and dot all the I's, not only when you put the deal together, but ongoing after that, that perpetual stewardship role that we take really seriously, working with any new landowner should the property pass on, that kind of thing. The other second way that we protect land is through land donations, and that's what we did with Central Rule. Those properties become preserved. And so our kind of portfolio of preserves is growing. Those are properties that we become the owner of and then take on the property taxes and any management issues that need to be addressed. And may or may not, it's up to the donor on what they want to see happen with the property. If, you know, some places may be suitable for some sort of trail or public access, others may just be set aside for a haven for wildlife, you know, so each case is different, but we have quite a few, not quite a few, we have a few preserves now and are kind of growing that. I guess that's about it, kind of what I guess we're focused on right now, just so you know, kind of honing in on that open space plan is, this is Kessler Mountains, which is, I actually grew up on Kessler, so it's very near and dear to my heart. I moved there in 1975 when I was 5 years old. If any of you happen to know, and I'm sure you do, Dr. Doug James. The house I grew up in was built for Doug James. Originally it was by the Fowler property, and you heard G. Fowler. They were my neighbors, were all growing up. And my family still has the property, and so this mountain is really important. We've been friends with Sharp, Frank Sharp, who started his father started the smokehouse, the building that we're in. It was built the year we moved here, actually, and if you are interested in kind of the history of the smokehouse, take a minute to look through some of these panels. It's a really neat history of the Sharps and the smokehouse on the mountain. But we are looking at, now that we're putting this easement on the 409 acres for the city, and the deal with that is people say, well, if it's a city park, why does it need an easement? Because, you know, just because the current administration says we're conserving this land to the XYZ does not mean that a future administration can't decide, oh, hey, we're going to divvy it up and sell this part, or we're going to lease this part to the botanical garden, or we're, you know, whatever it is. And so the easement will specify types of trails, you know, that type of different types of uses, and protect it in perpetuity. So we're really proud of the city of Fayetteville for recognizing that that is an important thing to do and investing in that. And we're starting to work with some other cities as well that are kind of doing the same thing. So with that easement, though, we really want to work with more landowners on not just Kessler, but Miller, Washington, and Stevenson Mountains, too, and try to add at least biological corridors for wildlife movement between these mountains that, you know, hopefully larger tracts, too, and then continue to focus on water quality and riparian use. And whatever else comes my way. So, I have any questions about any stuff? I have some stuff to hand out.
So I would have to agree with that sheriff help the land trust.
I like that question.
Well, we're money stuff in the
right.
Donate or help buy things. So what?
Yeah.
How could we talk to them?
I think always important that we have those ally groups that, a way, or I don't know, after I'm hearing y'all are thinking, if there's a way to do something like this, like talking to your membership, or co-hosting a hike together on Templar outreach type stuff. Certainly policy, you all do quite a bit of advocacy, and that's always good, like with the conservation incentives that seem to come up for review. You know, hopefully they're really going to be made permanent now, because they know they're having incentives for conservation incentives. But I think just spreading the word, and if there's ever, you know, if you are, you all are out in the natural world, landowners a lot, you know, if you know of a property that needs attention, or that is under threat, or a landowner who might be interested in working with this, certainly put it together with them.
Okay, could you include land like in Central Arkansas and the Southwest Arkansas Land Trust?
We can't spread out that far right now because of just limited capacity and resources, and we really just trying to stay focused on Northwest Arkansas.
So we need to work on something like
that. Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up. That's actually important. There's a big gap in Arkansas as far as local land trust. There is a Central or Land Trust of Arkansas, but I have not had a whole lot of luck really figuring out what they, I think they only take larger agriculture properties, maybe. North Carolina, for example, there are 32 land trusts, and they all work together. They each have, depending on the demographics and things of the county, they might focus on 2 to 6 counties. You know, I mean, it just depends on where they're at, and they are all busy, and they're focused, they're part of their communities, and they come together once a year and they talk about, you know, what's going on statewide. And I don't know that we need 32 in Arkansas, but it would be nice if there were some others. We get calls from St. Francis County and Pulaski County, and people wanting to conserve their land, and we don't really, unless it's a big project that the Nature Conservancy would be interested in, or that's unlimited, there's really nobody to refer them to. And for us to start getting so spread, you know, spread out, it's just would minimize our impact, I think, in Northwest Arkansas. So
another question.
We need more land trust. Yeah.
If I've got 100 acres and I give a conservation easement, that's get conservation easement, how does it affect my property taxes?
Well, it can cause them to go down because it takes away certain development potential, and that lowers the fair market value because, oh, nobody can now build a subdivision on it or whatever, and so it can be reassessed at a lower your property tax.
A lot.
It could potentially a lot, yeah. And then also you can take an income tax deduction off the value of the easement. So whatever amount the easement reduces the appraised value of your land, that's your charitable donation, and you can use that for 5 years for an income tax.
That's a good angle.
Yeah, that's a good angle for certain people for sure. Yeah. But yeah, down in Central Arkansas, that's something that the Land Trust Alliance, if you're interested in this, that's the national organization that there's about 1,800 land trusts across the country, and they're the sort of parent support organization. And they are broken up into regions. We're part of the Southeast region. And that is something that the Southeast Land Trust Alliance is aware that Arkansas has a hold as far as land trusts go. There are other, I mean, Georgia, Tennessee, North Carolina, South Carolina. I mean, they have several land trusts that work together. Arkansas does not. And so, yeah, promoting a land trust to be developed would be.
Right. You still have the same office phone as you did in your previous location?
Yes. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
973-9110?
No.
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 966-4666.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where you had that one before.
We have a website. I'm going to give you a save link if you're interested. You don't have to have one. And we got some stickers. I'd love you to take one, pass those around. Here's some more stickers if you need them. And also, we are trying to as you know, your nonprofit, increase our membership base. So if you're interested in being a member of the Land Trust, I'll leave these remittance envelopes up here as well. And this is my daughter, Eliza.
Hi, Eliza.
She just brought this down here, I think it's a future Sierra Club board member.
Nice work, Eliza.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Check it out. It's a place where you're good to network.
Sounds good. Okay. Y'all, I'm going to the building. I just turned the air on, but it takes a little while.
I actually appreciate a place that's not frigid. I dress for the summer.